How a boiler that was not descaled for more than a year can be super clean compared to this awful one that was supposedly regularly descaled? In this video, I'll not only answer this question, but I'll also show how you can prevent and monitor the scale buildup, how to descale your machine, and a 3 euros hack that was one of my best discoveries in the recent years, and something that has totally changed my approach to descaling, to the maintenance of my machine. First of all, when I bought my Gaia Classic 2006, I was informed that this machine was regularly descaled, and I don't think that the previous owner was hiding any information from me. I went to his place, he seemed pretty confident that his machine was in very good conditions. He didn't hesitate to test, to open the machine, to brew some coffee. Then I believe that, like many other users, he believed that he was doing the maintenance correctly, but he didn't. So how my ECM can be pretty clean if I didn't descale my boiler for 15 months to be more precise? What I do differently? The first and most important reason is that I use soft water. And if you attack the root cause, 90% of the problem is solved. If you watched my previous video, you know that I use a mix of tap water and Zerowater to keep the TDS below 110 parts per million and above 90. So that the water is not so hard that will accelerate the scaling process, but also not so soft that would make my coffee dough. For that, I use the Zerowater filter. That is the only portable filter that I know that removes 100% of the minerals. I also tested Brita, but Brita in my tests removed only 25% of the minerals. And in my case, it was not sufficient. The water here is around 240, 250 ppm. And by removing 25%, it was still above my desired levels. So I decided to use Zerowater. And yes, I know that some people have objections in using tap water in this mix because it has chlorine. But this is another topic that I'm not going to discuss now. And to measure the mix, I used a TDS meter that comes with the kit. And I was trying just to balance these levels between 110 and 90. It's a bit expensive. I spend between 15 to 20 euros per filter, and it lasts for about 8 liters of filtered water. But in my view, it's less expensive than descaling my machine every 2 or 3 months, or servicing my machine, considering that it's not only the cost of citric acid that is cheap, but also my time doing this maintenance, or even worse, if it reaches the state of my Gaia Classic, I had to disassemble the whole machine and also some parts like the solenoid valve, the group, and I spend lots of hours doing that. And it's not only for the maintenance, as I said, it's also important for the taste of the coffee. And I not only trusted that using soft water would be sufficient. To be honest, I didn't have any idea if it would be sufficient or not. I was monitoring the mushroom chamber, and whenever I lubricated the lever, I tried to check here in the group if there was any sign of lime scale. And since I didn't see any, I was comfortable or maybe lazy, and I didn't descale my machine for 15 months. But now I discovered a more efficient inspection hack that costs between 3 to 4 euros. And it was one of my best discoveries in the recent years. It totally changed my approach to descaling, and I'll show you how to use it. So stick with me. Another important detail. My estimation is that I make between 700 to 800 espressos per year, 2 or 3 per day, but not all the 365 days in the year. And if you make more than that, you may need shorter maintenance intervals, of course. But let's see how was this boiler inside after 15 months without any descaling. In my view, it was pretty okay. The black flakes were not in the boiler, but dropped when I removed the steam tube on the top. To my view, I didn't need to descale it now, but since I didn't do it in the last 15 months, I decided to descale and check the difference. In my previous videos, I shared some recommendations from channels like Whole Lotta Love, James Hoffman, Seattle Cough Gear, and the manufacturers that recommend descaling every 2 or 3 months if you use soft water. But after what I saw, I think you would be fine if you're using water below 110 TDS. You would be fine if you descale every 6 months, if you don't have any way to inspect it, or if you have, you may extend to 12 months like I did. How I descaled my machine? Well, first of all, since I would descale, I also backflushed my machine. I just used this blind part filter and 3 grams of kefizin. You put 3 grams of kefizin in the part filter, you lock here, and you pump the water for 10 seconds. And then you let rest for another 10 seconds, repeat it 5 times, and then you rinse only with water, same procedure, 5 times, 10 seconds pumping, 10 seconds resting, and you're done. Important information, you can only back flush if you have a three-way valve mechanic or a solenoid valve. Otherwise, you may run the risk of sending water with kefizin into the boiler and drink it later, which of course it's a risk for your health. Then I used citric acid. This is very cheap. You can buy a kilo for like 10 euros, $10 in the US. And you use 5% concentration. So this is a 3 liter boiler. Then I used 150 grams for 3 liters of water. It's important to dilute very well these grains, otherwise it may clog your machine. So what I did, I started with 400 mils of water that I preheated in the microwave for 45 seconds. And then I added 150 grams of citric acid, stirred a bit with a spoon. And in your case, if you still see some solids, you can heat a bit more, you can add more water. And when it's totally dissolved, you can add into your water tank. Then you complete with fresh water. I know that some people are not comfortable in using citric acid. Then you can follow the recommendations of the manufacturer of your machine. Some of them have their own solutions, like Gaja. They have their Gaja Descaler solution. Cyacle, the same. They are owned by the same company, so it's the same solution. Gaja Descaler has citric acid and lactic acid. Descal is another renowned product for descaling. It has a few more components that you can see here. In my research, I also found a product called Durgol. It's a Swiss brand descaler, and it's purely sulfamic acid. They claim it to be better because according to their website, sulfamic acid will have a faster effect, and you will need less volume of product. However, it's more expensive for boilers with more, for tanks, water tanks with more than 1 liter in volume. They recommend 2 bottles of descaler. And it's a bit expensive. I think 2 bottles cost about $20. I'll leave the links in the description for all those products, and then you can do your research. But one recommendation is not to use vinegar, because vinegar attacks some plastics. It may leave some taste, and it's going to be harder to remove. Lots of people use, I don't know what are their experience. If you're using vinegar, you may share your experience here. But I think the most used solution is citric acid. That's what I tested here. It went totally fine. I already brewed some coffees here, and I tasted the water after the scaling, and I didn't feel any smell or taste of acids. And my coffees are pretty nice, so I think it's working fine. Another point that I need to highlight, kefizin is only for back flushing, it's not for descaling. I know that this is obvious for many people, but I also received this question from lots of people asking the difference between descal and kefizin. Kefizin is a detergent, it's like the soap in your washing machine. It's for cleaning the oils of coffee in your group and in this discharge valve. You can also use to clean some parts like your filters, your puck screens, but it's not intended to be put into the water tank and into the boiler. Continuing the procedure, before starting this descaling process, since I had my machine open because I wanted to inspect the boiler inside, I used a hose, this hose here, to siphon the boiler because I had access to it. I opened and removed the steam tube. Then I just put some water in the hose, put it inside the boiler, and drained it completely, because then I think it would be more effective. But then another important information, if your boiler is totally empty, your machine should be off. If you let your machine on with without water in the boiler, you may damage your heating element. And then again, I diluted 150 grams of citric acid in this water tank that has 3 liters. The boiler has 750 mils in volume. So it would be like 4 times the size of the boiler. The water tank has 4 times the size of the boiler. So after draining the boiler, my machine was off. Then I turned it on and immediately activated the lever so that the boiler was being filled with this water, with this concentrate solution. When the water started to be dispensed by the group, I stopped and then I started the procedure. So I divided the descaling in four cycles, and in each of them, I back flushed with the blind portafilter for 20 seconds and let it rest for 30 seconds. Then I extracted a mug of solution using the hot water function from the steam wand, about 200, 250 mils, and let it rest for another 30 seconds. Then I extracted another mug from the group, another 200 or 250 mils, and then I let it rest for 20 minutes. Maybe too much, maybe not necessary. And then I repeated four times. After that, I rinsed, and for the rinsing, I did the same procedure. 20 seconds back flushing, one mug from the steam wand, one mug from the group, 30 seconds resting between each of these procedures, and then I didn't let it rest for 20 minutes because I was just running water through the machine. I didn't have to let it dissolve anything. So I ran about 6 liters of water and completely rinsed the machine. Why it's important to extract the solution from the steam wand and from the group, and also to backflush, because you want to have the scaling solution totally filling your group, your solenoid valve, or your three-way in this case, and also the steam wand and the tubes inside. Everywhere that hot water goes, you want it to be descaled, right? Some other disclaimers. I let the water achieve about 60 to 70 degrees, not more than that, because the hotter the solution, the faster is the action of these acids, and I didn't want corrosion in my machine. And during the 20 minutes that I let the solution dissolving the calcium here, my machine was off because I didn't want the water to be too hot. If you have a PID, you can set it to 70 degrees. I just didn't change the settings because it was pretty fast, that and the temperature was not going above 70, 75 degrees. So in my case, it was okay. In yours, probably also, but keep an eye on that. Another important information, the 30 seconds off when you are back flushing, then extracting water from the steam wand and from the group. Those 30 seconds are important for your pump to rest. It's to avoid the damage to the pump, okay? To check if you rinsed enough, you can get some water from your boiler and add some sodium bicarbonate. If it bubbles, it's because there's still some acid in the water and you need to rinse a bit more. If not, you should be fine. You can also taste some water, and if it's a bit sour, you keep rinsing. But of course, you can only do that if you're using citric acid. If you're using the descaler solution from Psycho Gaja or Durgol, then I don't recommend it because there are other chemical products in those solutions. And since I was descaling the machine, I back flushed with Cafisa. I would also lubricate the lever because if you have an E61 machine, you know that it makes a very annoying noise if you don't lubricate from time to time, especially when you back flush. And then I just did the whole maintenance. I just assembled this group, I removed the mushroom valve, the lever, the discharging valve. I disassembled each of those components, cleaned, lubricated each of the O-rings inside. I checked if any of them was damaged and they needed replacement. It was dried, but it was all fine, so I just lubricated and put it back. I believe this is a more simple procedure that many owners of E61 machines are used to do. There are lots of videos available on YouTube. But if you want me to make one, just let me know. I can make a video about it, but I think there is enough information about it. And then this is what I found after descaling the boiler. I think it is better, but I don't think that I needed to do it right now. What do you think? But how I made this image inside the boiler and how you can inspect yours. Well, first you need to disassemble your machine. And in my case, I removed the steam tube so that I can put this 3 euros camera inside the boiler and see inside. And this is the little hack that I mentioned. It's amazing the quality of the image for only 3 euros. And in my case, the boiler has a hole big enough to insert the camera. I don't know in your case if it's possible, but of course you need to drain the boiler first. I don't know if this is waterproof, but even if it is, I think it's going to be hard to see anything with water inside. And also the boiler needs to be cool. So if you feel that it's still a bit warm, let it cool down for a while, because if there's a little bit of steam, it's gonna blur the images. But after your machine is completely cool, you can make those images that I just made. And these cameras can be connected to any mobile phone. Well, you need to choose the right one for iPhones or Androids. And they come with an adapter for you to connect to your laptop as well. I'll leave the link in the description in case you want to buy, but just don't spy on others because it's not nice, and you will probably be infringing some laws in your country. And from now on, I'll keep using soft water, my water below 110 TDS, monitoring the mushroom chamber. And from time to time, maybe after 6 months or even 12, depending on what I see inside, the mushroom chamber, I'm gonna use this camera to inspect inside the boiler. Of course, I'm not gonna do it regularly because you need to disassemble the machine, but it's great to have this option. And I will not do the preventive descaling anymore every 3 or 6 months, now that I know that 12 months is sufficient for my condition. 2 or 3 cups a day, maybe 700, 800 a year, and using a water with a TDS below 110. But of course, I'll keep monitoring the chamber. And I'm not gonna do because one, it's time consuming, and second, because I think it's a bit aggressive. So I prefer not to do if I can clearly see that it's not necessary. But just for the sake of testing, I may use pure tap water in this machine for maybe 3 or 6 months to see what happens, and inspect the boiler maybe after 3 and 6 months. But well, only if you think that's useful. So let me know if you want me to do this test, if it's interesting, because otherwise I'm not gonna sacrifice the quality in my cup just to get this information, okay? And in case you want to see how bad it can go if you neglect the maintenance of your machine, just check this video here, and thanks for watching.